Hello friends, I'm Naval Yemul, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see Scilab, Scalars and Vectors Part 1. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to perform vector calculations on Scilab. Content: introduction, initializing vectors in Scilab, mathematical operations on vectors. Introduction. Scilab, just like MATLAB, focuses on matrices for handling huge data. A matrix is just a rectangular array of rows m and columns n. We refer to it in mathematics as an m into n matrix. When a matrix has a single row of numbers, we call it as a row vector. So here m shows a row vector where the matrix has a single row. Where the matrix represents a single column is called as a column vector, where n shows a column vector. So let us see how to initialize vectors in Scilab, that is row vector and column vector. Basically, vectors are denoted by a square brackets in Scilab. You need to remember this point. Whenever you want to input a vector, square brackets are used in Scilab. A sequence of numbers separated by a comma or simply space defines a row vector. So whenever we are giving a row vector, comma or simply a space is used to define a row vector. For example, here m is a variable and there are 5 elements in the square bracket: 35, 45, 65, 79, 23 represents a row vector, or else you can give a space also between the elements. In the same way, the same data can also be arranged in a column vector. Here the sequence of numbers are separated by the semicolon. Here m is, the elements are separated by the semicolon, that is 35 semicolon 45 semicolon 65 semicolon 79 semicolon 23. The vector we get is a column vector, that is in one column. So we'll give a quick calculations on a Scilab window. So this is a Scilab console window where we perform the same operations what we have done now. So I'm giving a vector, row vector, with a square brackets and the elements in that. You can give a space or you can give a comma also, there is no problem, and just press enter. The m, that is row vector, is defined. In the same way, we can define a column vector, that n, you can take any variable, same square brackets, but between the elements you need to give a semicolon. Semicolon, then a element, then semicolon, then an element. So just type enter, you get the n as a column vector. So this is a method to give a row vector and this as a column vector. So Scilab has some shorthand notations. If the vector is an arithmetic progression of numbers, for example, to define 1 to 10, we have a command as follows: a is equal to 1 colon, you need to remember here, it is colon 1 colon 10, where you get the output as 1 to 10. Here the starting number is 1, increment value in the middle, and the upper limit at the last. So 1 is the first number, 10 is the last number, and middle number, that is incrementing value. So you get the output from 1 to 10. Suppose if you want to specify all the even numbers from 2 to 20, the function or the command would be 2 colon 2 colon 20. That first 2 is for the first number and this 20 is the last number, and from 2 to 20 the increment should be 2. So you get the output as 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. So we'll do this two calculations on the Scilab window, console window. So I'll take a vector. So the shorthand for to type 1 to 10, that is 1 colon, then 1, that is incrementing 1, then last number should be 10. I'll just press enter. So we'll get a row vector from 1 to 10. In the same way, we can take a just a minute. I've taken square bracket 2:2:20. So you get all the even numbers starting from 2 and ending at 20. So you get all the even numbers from starting from 2 to 20. I'll clear this console window. To clear the console window, the command is clc enter. So it will ask to clear the console. Just clear it. We'll go further. The increment, that is the starting value and end value, can be a fraction also. Here, let us see an example. 0:0.3:1, where 0.3 is in fraction. The first number is 0 and it is incremented as 0.3. And the last number is closest to the ending value. It is not exactly the end value. Whenever you have a fraction, you will get this case. If we are interested in creating a row vector or a column vector of all elements 0, it can be done using a special 0 function. So in Scilab, it is a special function called 0 function, where you need to get, if you want all row vector or a column vector as 0 elements, the command is like 0, 1, 5, where 1 first place, 1 indicates that is row, and 5 indicates there are 5 zeros. In the same way, we can do for column vector, that is zeros, this is a function zeros, 2, there are 2 zeros with 1. 1 indicates it is a column. So 0, 0. We can see in a Scilab window here. Suppose I'll take a D element, D is equal to zeros, 1, that is row, comma 5, and I'll complete the bracket, press enter. So in one row there are 5 elements and all 5s are zeros. I'll take other E as zeros in bracket 3, 1. The 3 indicates there are 3 zeros and 1 is a column. So 3 zeros in column. So think, pause the video for a few seconds, list down the various vector operations you know. Let us see the vector operations we can perform on the Scilab. So mathematical operations on vectors. The various mathematical operations possible on vectors are listed as follows. We can do addition of vectors, subtraction, multiplication, division, element wise multiplication, element wise division, then transpose. The first, addition. The addition of the two vectors A and B is performed using plus operator. Both operators must be of same size. It is not possible to add a row vector and a column vector. So whenever we are using a addition or plus operator, the two should be a column vector or two should be a row vector. Suppose here A and B both are a row vector, you can add this by a operator plus A plus B, adding two vectors, you get the output as 10+5=15, 20+10=30, 30+15=45. In the same way, you get subtraction. Here we use minus operator, very simple, and both should be of row vector or a column vector. So A minus B, the answer would be 5, 10 minus 5, 5, 20 minus 10, 10, 30 minus 15, 15. So we'll have a quick calculations here. Like if I give a vector as 5 (10)(15), bracket complete, a row vector is defined. B is equal to 15 (20)(25), just press enter, you will get two vectors defined. You can add a plus b is equal to a minus b, enter. Okay, so I'll, you can see the calculations, very simple. So further we can go with the multiplication. In multiplication, while performing multiplication of vectors, one should be in row and other vector should be in column, then only you can perform multiplication operation. For example, here a is in vector, row vector, and b is a column vector. Here you can see the semicolon between them, between the elements, it represents a column vector. Here a into b gives you a 700. Here a is a row vector and b is a column vector. For division, is usually performed between a and b as row vectors. Here you can see a and b is, the operator used is slash sign here for division. So a divided by b, you get 2. So this is element wise multiplication. For element wise multiplication, the operator we use is dot and asterisk. That is dot multiplication, that is element wise multiplication. Here also the condition is same. You need to have vectors of same size, a and b, two row vectors. Here we can use dot asterisk, that dot multiplication. We get first element is multiplied with first element of vector b, that is 10 into 5, you get 50. In the same way the calculations are performed. Element wide division, the operator is used as dot slash here. So a dot slash b, you get the answer with element wise division. These are the references. Thank you.